Wouldn't be the end of the week, of course, without a small libation for us all and our favourite wine connoisseur.
Yes, it's Tom time. My heart's going boom, bang a bang, and in honour of the Eurovision Song Contest tomorrow night, this week we've gone all continental, ooh la la.
Nul point.
Oh, nul point. Listen, but it's the moment all music lovers have been waiting for, isn't it?
The Eurovision Song Contest or this wine review? I don't know.
Do you watch Eurovision fan, Tom?
Yes.
You can't lie.
Listen, when I was growing up, I loved it. Didn't we all love it when we were growing up? You know, the excitement of...
What was your favourite song from years...
Ever?
From years gone by?
Or anyone that you can remember.
Cliff Richard. Congratulations.
Yeah.
He won it, didn't he?
But this is a lovely excuse for us, rather than focusing on one country and one region, to get out all around Europe.
Isn't it great fun? Because wine is made in just about every European country you can think of. You know, maybe not Norway or Sweden, I'll have to think about that one, but the rest of them all make wine, so you could have your own wine Eurovision contest
quite easily. Tomorrow night.
We've not got Norway or Sweden in today, don't worry, we're not going to throw any curveballs.
Thank goodness
Where are we going first today, Bud?
Well, listen, we are going for three of the representatives who are in the final tomorrow night.
Okay.
So this is a kind of mini prediction here. I think we could predict the winner quite easily.
And we've got red, white and a rosé as well.
Red, white and a rosé, we're mixing it up. And the first one is representing France.
Excuse me a moment, Tom. Thank you.
Oh, Michelle, you've never looked better.
Oh, dear, that's the way that's supposed to go.
That's better. Yeah, that's really nice.
Yep.
OK, representing France...
I don't think that's the way that's supposed to go. Right.
Maybe Stephen would look better in that.
Do you want to try it?
I'm going to concentrate on the wine, I think.
We have La Vieille Capitale 2009. It's £5.49 in Majestic currently. That's a special offer. Comes from the south of France. It's full-bodied. It's harmonious. That was my pun, my joke. Music, harmony, and have a little go at it. I think it's lovely. Filled with lovely kind of black currant fruit. Lovely and smooth.
Oh, mon dieu.
It's very nice, isn't it? Smooth tannins, very silky, very easy to
drink. Taste of the hedgerows.
It's got that lovely berry fruit, Steve, exactly right. Kind of summer and autumn fruits. Absolutely beautiful.
And that's the French song that we're hearing there. Good luck, guys.
Oh, is it? Oh, well, we'll need some luck, but good luck to them.
Apparently, I'm hearing it's currently the favourite to win as well. I wonder, will it win our wine?
Well, it may do.
Euro challenge
well,
tonight.
It's a lovely wine. I think it deserves to.
How many points, Stephen?
I really like that. It's out of 12, isn't it? Eurovision.
Out of 12.
Yeah, I'm going to say 10 points.
10 points for that. So that's pretty. That's a pretty good
song. Okay.
It'd be tough to beat that.
What's the next country, Tom?
Next country we have representing the wine is representing Spain.
Mm-hmm. Hold on a moment.
Oh hey. Oh, Tenerita. I didn't know any of this was going to happen. I might have not come in. Listen.
Do you want to take out my mouth?
Representing Spain, we have the Torres Viña Sol white wine. At the moment, it's £5.97 in Asda. Now, listen, try this one. This is a real... Spain's in with a chance with this. Because it's a lovely wine. It's fresh. It's got those lovely
flowing notes. I like this one.
It's clean as a whistle.
Yeah.
Whistle. Another music.
Clean as a whistle.
Lovely kind of mandarin orange. Any other notes? A few notes, I think, Stephen.
This is my favourite for a long while. It's a really nice wine.
Listen, it's a wine that's very widely available. It's in all the supermarkets, and there always seems to be a deal on it. You find it for a fiver. And I think for the summertime, it's another crisp, fresh, lovely kind of wine.
Do you know something? I like the wine and I like the music. This is the Spanish entry as well that's playing.
This sounds as if it's quite catchy, isn't it?
It is quite catchy.
Yeah, this could be... Well, it depends what the wine scores from Stephen, though, the judge.
Well, I do like it, but I still like that one better. I'm going to say huit point.
No.
So it's a judge has spoken.
I'm sorry.
Right, OK, so that's... We've been to France... We've been to Spain. Where are we going
now, Tom?
We're finishing off with the host nation this year, which is Germany.
Hold on. A German sausage.
I'll leave that one.
I think Germany's just broken off diplomatic relations.
It's a German sausage.
There are even worse props I could have imagined, so that's not so bad.
I know, think of what I could have come up with.
But the German wine is a rosé, unusual for Germany.
From the Prince Harry was here.
This is the Dr. Lucen Villa Wolf Pinot Noir Rosé. It's the 2010 vintage, and this wine costs £8.99, so it's the most expensive.
It's a kind of funny rosé, isn't it?
It's a pale rosé. It comes from a shop called 1-to-1, which is in Bath Street in Glasgow, and online, Inverarity 1-to-1. But have a little sniff and a taste of it. I think the Germans have done really well with this one. Lovely fruit. It's got that hint of sweetness that a lot of rosés have, but it's got the strawberries, the cherries, a lovely wine from the south of Germany, where it's really quite warm. It's not the cool climate. It's down from the Pfalz. It's a region where they can grow peaches and kiwi fruits and all sorts of things.
In Germany,
I mean, you have to go down there and see. It's a lovely kind of continental climate. And this wine, I think, is a beauty. £8.99 from 1-to-1.
I like the song more than I like the wine.
It's
too sweet.
It's a little bit sweet, Stephen. If you don't like the sweet wines, maybe you should avoid this one, yeah. But some people will love it. Easy to drink for the summer.
Well, obviously, they're going for the double this year, Germany. Selena, I'm going to do it 2 in a row. I like it, but I have to say, nothing's going to move me off the Spanish.
Oh, well, but I think Stephen's got the final vote, hasn't he?
He's got the points.
No point.
No point?
No point.
That's harsh.
No, I'm sorry.
That's too harsh.
So who wins then?
Well, listen, bringing up the rear, Germany. We've got Spain, very creditable, 8 points.
Oh, Canavan!
And the winner
is... Piece of German sausage?
The winner is France with Le Vieil Capital.
Ah, we're looking for France.
That's our Euro prediction. 5 points.
Now, is there such a thing as Irish wine? Any decent Irish wine?
No, I don't think they make any wine in Ireland, no.
No, Guinness.
But Guinness is the nearest to come. The black stuff here is about the weirdest thing.
What have you got down here? Well, I only asked because I didn't have much to do in work today, so I decided...
You've been busy in the old prop store here today, Michelle, haven't you?
Yes, I've got it here, Stephen. Hold on.
Oh, no, it's Jedward.
Flying the flag for Jedward.
Yeah, well...
You've got a joke about the UK entry, haven't you?
Good luck with that. What's blue and can't sing?
Blue and can't sing, huh?
Blue.
That's shocking.
What are we doing next week when all this will be behind
us?
This will just be a memory.
Next week we're on just before the start of the Chelsea Flower Show. And how I always give you nice descriptions for the wines?
Yes.
We're doing floral wines.
Floral?
Wines that I think have got something floral about them. Aromatic.
What will Michelle have in store for you then?
I know, I think this is bad for props. Wait till you see next week.
I dread to think.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.